Google Glass is a new type of wearable computer that looks a little like a set of designer everyday glasses. It is voice activated or can be controlled with a variety of different gestures on the side.
It has an array of basic commands for you to say, for you to give it information. You basically just talk to it and it responds and it searches on the internet for all the information that you need.
So there are lots of different issues that come about due to Parkinson's. It's a progressive condition that affects lots of different things, mainly movement-wise. So people have, for example, a tremor or lots of stiffness. They have issues with doing lots of day-to-day activities.
So in this research, we're looking at the ways in which people with Parkinson's can use this technology to help them, provide them with prompts whilst they're out and about, reminders to help them live more independently, but also the ways in which it might allow them to use things such as smartphones and mobile phones in a simpler way, because it's a lot easier for them to use their voice, for instance, to interact with this technology as it is to use their hands with a normal mobile phone.
So one of the things that came up a lot in the workshop that we did with the volunteers was this loss of confidence due to having the Parkinson's, and kind of a lack of desire to go out and about by themselves, really, for fear of something happening in relation to the symptoms. For example, if they have a freezing episode when they're out and about on their own. And what Google Glass can offer there is a system that will allow them to, will support them as they go out and about in their daily lives and give them some connection to a loved one at home, for example.
The feedback that we've received from participants has actually been really, really positive. Many of them feel as though that the technology might make them feel more confident whilst out and about. It provides an easy way for them to make phone calls with people that perhaps they need guidance and advice from. For people with Parkinson's, there's lots of challenges that they might have in terms of taking their medication at the right period of time. So they've also made lots of recommendations about how the technology might provide prompts and cues for them to take their medication at that right moment, because it's absolutely critical that they get it at that right time each day.
I suppose the main thing to come up from the deployments really was how much they enjoyed it, how much they enjoyed using it, how much potential they could see in the technology, and how helpful it could possibly be for them in the future to help support them in their Parkinson's and remind them to do different things like take their pills or remind them for their appointments, for example.
So Newcastle University has got world-leading research and reputation in human-computer interaction. In the digital interaction group which led this research, we have designers such as myself, computer scientists, domain specialists such as speech and language therapists, all kind of working together to contribute towards projects and to bring new technologies to be. The most important thing that we do throughout is that we work with users and communities that end up using these technologies. And by working with these communities and making sure they take a lead in the design activities, we tend to feel as though our research has a bigger impact.
Favourite part of the project for me is always working with the participants. Some of them I've got some personal connections with through other research, and some of them were brand new people I'd never met before. It's always really great to see how enthusiastic they are about the things that we do here at Newcastle University, and especially with something like Glass, which is so new, you know, seeing their enthusiasm for it and how great they thought it was really, really good.
Whenever we give participants a new technology, I think we're initially quite sceptical about how they might receive it. Maybe they might think we're giving them technologies for the sake of it. And actually, they saw really great value in what we were doing, and they're really committed as well in taking part in the research in the future.